Algebra 2, Lesson 73, More on Radical Denominators. So this should be a pretty quick video. It's just a continuation on what we learned a few lessons ago with multiplying denominators that have radical exponents, radicals by their conjugate, meaning the same polynomial with a different sign in the middle. So I'm just gonna skip over, we'll do this one as a refresher, and then we'll do the tough example. So we'll start with example 73.2. Now, the major difference between these that makes them a little bit more difficult than previous versions is we have multiple terms in both the numerator and the denominator, which means we're going to have to be foiling on both the numerator and the denominator. Now, again, we have to first identify our conjugate, which is going to be 4 minus root 3 times square root of 2, and then we'll multiply both the numerator and... I just put a plus mark, didn't I? Why would I do that? Minus 3 root 2. We'll multiply both the numerator and the denominator by both of those, which is essentially multiplying by the value of 1. So not changing the number, just rewriting it. Didn't see that one coming. And again, if you find multiple terms in a fraction, it's a good rule of thumb to go ahead and put them inside of parentheses. So we'll go ahead and start the FOIL process on the numerator. 4 times 4 is going to give me 16. Outside times the outside, 4 times negative 3 root 2 is going to give me negative 12 root 2. Inside times the inside, negative root 2 times 4 gives me negative 4 root 2. And then the last times the last, negative root 2 times negative 3 root 2 ends up giving me positive 3 times 2. So that's my numerator. And then I'll go ahead and I'll do FOIL on the denominator. So 4 times 4, or first times first, gives me 16 again. Outside times the outside. 4 times negative 3 root 2. Negative 12 root 2 again. Inside times the inside. Positive 4 times positive 3 root 2 gives me positive 12 root 2. And the last times the last, which is... positive 3 root 2 times negative 3 root 2 is going to give me negative 9 times 2. Now let's go ahead and simplify these. We'll start by adding like terms. So for the numerator, we'll simplify and add like terms. So following rules of Pemdas, I'm going to do this multiplication first in the numerator. So that's going to become plus 6. So when I add like terms, I'm going to have 16 plus 6, which is going to give me 22. And then here I have negative 12 root 2 minus 4 root 2. These are like terms because they have the same radical. Negative 12 minus 4 gives me negative 16 root 2. So that's my numerator. Now for the denominator, we have to multiply first. So that's going to become negative 18. And then negative 12 root 2 and positive 12 root 2 cancel each other out. So then on the denominator, we just have 16 minus 18, which gives us negative 2. Now, this is almost our final answer. The reason why it's not our super duper final answer is because it can be reduced. The reason why is because both 22 and 16 can be divided by negative 2. There's two ways to do this. We can either divide each term by the denominator, in which case 22 divided by negative 2 would become negative 11. Negative 16 divided by negative 2 would become positive 8, and then root 2 would be written on the end. Or we could factor the numerator, and we could rewrite it like this. It could be 2 times 11 minus... I'm sorry, we can make it. We could factor out a negative 2, and then we'd have negative 11 plus 8 root 2 over negative 2, and then we could cancel it that way, which would also give us negative 11 plus 8 root 2. So in the end, our final answer, negative 11 plus 8 root 2. All right, if you think you've got it, then you can go ahead and start your homework. If you need to see one more example, I'll do one more harder problem. And I'm going to go ahead and magically insert that right here. Ta-da. Okay, again, step one, identify the conjugate of the denominator. So in this case, we're going to have 3 root 3 plus, not minus, 2 root 2. And then the numerator, same thing. So we're just multiplying by a value of 1, rewriting the number and not actually changing it. I'm going to insert parentheses around both the all of these polynomials, so that way I know I need to FOIL. And then I'll go ahead and start FOILing. So with the numerator, first times the first, 3. Root 12 times 3 root 3. Well, I know the whole number is going to be 9, and then square root of 12 times square root of 3 is going to become square root of 36. That can be simplified later, but I'll do that later. Let's just do one step at a time. So that's first times the first, and then we'll do outside times the outside. So 3 root 12 times 2 root 2 is going to give me positive 6 root 24. Inside times the inside, negative 2 root 3 times 3 root 3 is going to give me negative 6. Oh, I'm running out of space here. Negative 6 times 3, because square root of 3 times square root of 3 just gives me number 3. Excuse me. And then last times the last, negative 2 root 3 times positive 2 root 2 is going to give me negative 4 root 6. That is my numerator. So again, this one's a little bit more complex. We're going to have a lot more simplification to do in the end. Now, FOIL on the denominator. First times the first, 3 root 3 times 3 root 3 is going to give me 9 times 3. Outside times the outside, 3 root 3 times 2 root 2 is going to give me plus 6 root 6. Inside times the inside, negative 2 root 2 times positive 3 root 3 gives me minus 6 root 6. And again, I'm looking to make sure that these are the same term with opposite signs. Excuse me. That's how I know I'm doing things correctly. And then we'll do last times the last. So negative 2 root 2 times positive 2 root 2 gives me negative 4 times 2. So I'm finished FOILing. Now I need to do a little bit of simplification. So I'll go ahead and do that next. First, I'll start with these radicals in this numerator. So square root of 36 can be written as the number 6. So this can become 9 times 6. Square root of 24, if we factor that off to the side, we get 2 and 12. 12 is going to factor into 2 and 6. 6 will factor into 2 and 3. I've got a pair of 2s, so this can be rewritten as 2 square root of 2 times 3, or 6. So, and then that 2 root 6 replaces 24, so that 2 gets multiplied by this 6. So that gives me 12 root 6. minus 6 times 3 is going to be minus 18. Excuse me, I need to drink some water. And then this last term is not going to simplify anymore, so we just have minus 4 root 6. This first term I can multiply, 9 times 6 is going to give me 54. So what I actually have in this numerator is 54 plus 12 root 6 minus 18 minus 4 root 6. excuse me, I need to get some water. Okay. Now let's simplify the denominator. So 9 times 3 here is just going to become 27. 6 root 6 and negative 6 root 6 are going to cancel. And then 4 times 2 is going to give me negative 8. So now I can combine like terms and simplify my final answer. So like terms in the numerator, 54 minus 18 is going to give me, whew, this is a tough one, 44, 36. So I have 36, and then plus 12 root 6 minus 4 root 6 is going to give me plus 8 root 6. So my numerator is 36 plus 8 root 6. My denominator, 27 minus 8, is going to give me 19. And I believe that is our final answer. Yep, that is our final answer right there. There's no more simplification we can do because although 36 can be divided by 19, 8 cannot. So that's it for this lesson. If you have any questions, let me know on Moodle, and I will see you in class.